Hi guys, this is Rekha from EduReka. Today's session is all about WordPress. Now, a lot of people have this misconception that WordPress is all about creating and publishing blogs. While that might be true, there's more to WordPress than you think. Today, we'll see how to create our own theme and run our own website on WordPress. So guys, there's a lot to cover today. Let's move ahead and take a look at today's agenda. I'm going to begin with what is WordPress. We look at a few features of WordPress, and we'll also see a few websites that were created using WordPress. Next, we'll see the prerequisites and how to install and set up WordPress on our local systems. Finally, we'll create our own theme on WordPress and run our own website. All right. Now, before we move ahead with our first topic, I want to show you all the end results, what exactly we're going to build today. So guys, this is going to be the website that we're going to create. It's not a static website. So if I click on About, it takes me to an about page. It is a full-on website. Like if I go to breeds, it's going to show me different breeds of dogs and cats and all of that. Okay, it's a working website. We're going to develop this entire thing in today's session. So without any further delay, let's get started. All right, we'll move on to introduction to WordPress. Now, I'm sure all of you have heard of WordPress, but what exactly does WordPress do? Now, WordPress is a content management system which is used for building and publishing blogs and websites. Now, this is a free and open source tool which powers 26% of the web. Now, there has to be a reason why so many developers and organizations prefer WordPress. Now, actually, there are a couple of reasons why, and let's discuss a few of those reasons. WordPress is a very user-friendly tool, and a WordPress website can be built and run in a matter of minutes. And you won't even need any technical expertise to do this. Now, apart from that, WordPress is flexible and adaptable. So guys, when WordPress was initially released, it was designed to support small-scale blogging. But now it's used to power complex websites for large multinational corporations, manage small businesses, and create personal blogs. Another impressive feature of WordPress is that it comes with a ton of plugins. Now, plugins are available even for the most specific tasks. Let's say you want to add shopping carts or you want to add galleries and contact forms. You have plugins for all of these things. You can also purchase and install hundreds of custom plugins from third-party developers. Also, WordPress has a huge community of users. Now, because WordPress is free and open source, it's supported by millions of people all around the world. All right, so those were a few features of WordPress. Now, to show you all how far WordPress has reached, let's look at some interesting WordPress facts. Now, users make 41.7 million new posts each month, which means that approximately 1.4 million new posts are created every single day. The next fact is that there are approximately 45,000 plugins on WordPress with 1.3 billion downloads. That is a lot, which means that a lot of people actually use so many plugins from WordPress. Now, WordPress also powers more than 26% of the web, which is a huge part. Now, the reason behind WordPress's success is the fact that it can be deployed everywhere. So let's say from small scale blogs to complex websites and even small businesses. According to the statistical information on PayScale, the average WordPress developer earns up to $50,000. Also, a recent survey of global internet content management system usage showed that WordPress is responsible for an additional 1.1 million domains every 6 months. So guys, those were a few facts about WordPress. Now let's move ahead and take a look at a few websites that were created using WordPress. So first we have the New Yorker Times. Now, even though this website looks quite simple, there's actually a lot of work behind this website. And believe it or not, it's actually not very hard to make websites like these. All right, we'll be creating one like this today. Then there is the Walt Disney Company, and we also have the Usain Bolt website. Now, there are hundreds of such websites which are created on WordPress, and the reason is its simplicity. If you'd ask me why so many people prefer WordPress, I'd say because it's very simple to use. It's extremely user-friendly. There's a vast community of WordPress users, and if you have any technical issues, the community will help you out. All right. I believe it's extremely simple to create a website and run it on WordPress. All right. So before we install WordPress on our systems, let's look at a few requirements. Now, in order for WordPress to run on our systems, we need these three things. It needs PHP, it needs Apache, and it needs MySQL. Now, there are many tools out there that will automatically install all three of them for you. To mention a few, there is MAMP, there's LocalBy Flywheel, there's VirtualBox, and so on. But if you guys already have one of these tools installed on your system, then great. But if you don't, and if you're new to this, then I'd suggest you install the LocalBy Flywheel. It's very user-friendly, and also I'll be showing you how to install it step by step. All right, so let's start. Now, what you can do is open up a new tab on your web browser and search for Local by Flywheel. All right, now click on this free download button and choose your platform. Okay, mine is Windows. And also fill in the small detail form. Click on Get It Now. All right, so guys, this might take a few minutes. So by the time this downloads, I want to tell you all that since we're locally installing WordPress on our computer, only we'll be able to see our website. Okay, this is just a learning tutorial. I'm not going to actually publish the work on the internet. But if you want to publish your website, I think you'll need to pay around $13 to $15 for web hosting. So I just wanted to give a quick disclaimer that we're not actually going to publish the website on the internet because this is a learning tutorial and this is just for practice. But if you want to go ahead and publish, I think you can look it up on the internet. You'll have to pay around $15. So I'm not sure. Okay, so it's installing a VirtualBox and a host machine. It'll just take a few minutes now. And so guys, now what we have is we have a local dev environment copy of WordPress on our computer. Okay, so we can do anything on WordPress. Even if we have any errors, it's okay because we'll be the only ones who'll be seeing it. So this is just for practice purpose and for learning purpose. All right, so once the virtual machine and the local host is set up, this is what Local by Flywheel will look like. Now, what you have to do is go ahead and click on create a new site. Right now, just give a name to your website. I'm going to call it Pet Adoption. Y'all can do the same or y'all can choose something else. Now, I'm going to click on preferred default options. Okay, click on continue. Now, you need to give a username and a WordPress password. Okay, just remember the username and the password because you'll need this. My WordPress username is going to be Edureka and I'm just going to give some password. All right, so I created a WordPress username and a password. Guys, remember the username and the password because you'll be using this later on when you want to log into your WordPress account. Okay, so once this environment is set up, you'll have an own dev environment copy of WordPress on your computer. So it's adding the pet adoption site. So now we have our website set up. Now what you can do is you can click on this view site, which is over here. All right, so click on view site. So now we have our own WordPress copy. So this is the name of our website, which is Pet Adoption. Okay, so this is like a local copy of WordPress. Okay, now what you can do is you can start by logging in. Okay, since we are building our own theme, let's log in as the site's admin. Okay, to do that, what you have to do is go to the address bar and after this slash, just type wp-admin. All right, click enter. Now, given the username and the password that we entered just a few minutes ago, and log in. All right, so now we've landed on the WordPress admin dashboard. Okay, now this is what the WordPress developers can see. Anybody who's viewing our website will not be able to see this dashboard. There are various categories over here. There's posts, there's media, there's pages, comments, appearance, plugins, and all of these. Now, before we get involved in this, it's important to locate the WordPress folder on our local system. Okay, we'll be spending most of our time in that folder. So what you have to do is go open up Local by Flywheel. And on the top left corner over here, you'll see that your site's name. What you do is right click on it, click on Show Folder. Okay, so this is our folder over here. This folder is basically inside your user account. Okay, it's in the home directory inside the user account. So you can see the path over here, computer, local desk C, users, test, and local sites. All right, so here you can see this local sites. Now this folder was just created. This is a brand new folder. And this folder contains our project. See, it says pet adoption. All right, now let's look at the WordPress files. Okay, so go to app over here. Now these are basically all the files that power WordPress. And one of the most important folders in this is the WP content folder over here. So let's click on that. Now, if you open it, you'll see another folder called themes over here, correct? Within this folder, you can see that there are already three existing themes. There's 2015, 2017, and 2016. All right, now in this session, we'll be learning how to create a new folder over here in order to make our own theme. Okay, so we'll be spending most of our time over here. Okay, now that we have WordPress set up on our local systems, we can start learning how WordPress works and how to go about coding. Okay, so guys, let's start with the demo. We're going to begin with creating a new folder in the theme folder. Okay, so we're going to start by creating a theme. So go ahead and open up your site. In case you've forgotten how to do that, all you have to do is go to Local by Flywheel and click on View Site. Okay, this loads up your site. And the next step would be to log in as admin, which is wp-admin. Okay, you log in like that. All right, so this is what the dashboard looks like. Now, since we're going to create our own theme, let's go to the Appearance tab over here, okay, and click on Themes. Now, these are the themes that WordPress offers. You can customize an available theme, or you can start fresh and make your own theme. Now, remember the folder that we were exploring a while ago, where we saw within the Themes folder, right here, within the Themes folder, there were three other themes, 2015, 2017, and 2016. Now, these are basically those three themes. See, 2017, there's 2015, and there's 2016. Now, what we want to do is we want to create our own theme over here. Now, before we start, I want to tell you all that it's very easy to create a theme. So don't start panicking. Now, in order to have your own theme, open up the WordPress folder. All right, this was the WordPress folder. Wait, let me direct you back. Okay, open up local sites, click on pet adoption, which is the name of your website, and then go to app, public, and go to WP content. All right, click on themes. Over here, what you're going to do is you're going to create a new folder. So right click and go to new and folder. You can name your theme whatever you want. I'm going to name it theme 101. All right. So our first step is done. We've created a theme folder. Now the second step is to create two files in this folder. Since we'll be coding these files, let's open them in a code editor. All right. Let me just minimize everything first. So this is the folder that we just created. Now, our next step is to create two files in this folder. Now, because we're going to code in these files, we're going to be using a code editor. In my case, I'll be using Visual Studio Code. I've always been using this editor. I think it's very user-friendly. So I'll be coding using Visual Studio Code. Y'all can use any code editor you like. There's Sublime Text, there's Atom, and all of that. So what you can do is just drag the theme folder that you created and drop it into your code editor. Okay, so I'll drag it and I'll drop it into my code editor. All right, now you can see there is theme 101 over here. Okay, I'm just going to zoom in so that y'all can see whatever I'm doing clearly. All right, so now we have our theme 101 folder over here. Now go ahead and create two files over here. All right, so let's open up the first file and name this index.php. All right, and open up another file. Let's name it style.css. Guys, be careful about the names. You'll have to name the files exactly like I'm naming them because WordPress will be looking for these files. Okay, so you can't name them anything else. Make sure that you name the files exactly like how I'm naming them. So usually we use CSS to design a web page, but in WordPress, there is more to CSS. So now let's look at our next step. Now what we're going to do is in our CSS file, we're going to give a small description about our theme. So how do we do that? Now we open up a CSS comment. To do that, add a slash and an asterisk. And then to close the comment, it is an asterisk followed by a slash. So we just open and close a CSS comment over here. Now, what we're going to do is we need to add our theme description. So type with me. Let's start by theme name. Okay, I'm going to name it pet adoption. Y'all can name a different website or y'all can create a different website depending on what you like. Now, in order to show you what exactly is happening by doing this, save this file and open up WordPress themes. Let's refresh this. Now, here you can see pet adoption. Now, this is a new theme that we created. We named it pet adoption. So here's the name which says pet adoption. Okay, this is the theme name that I just gave. Okay, now let's add a little more of description because it says by anonymous. Okay, let's give an author to this. So close this and go back to your CSS file and let's add an author. Okay, I'm going to say Zulekha. And let's also give a version. We'll say version 1.0. Now this version is just a random number. All right, so you can say any version. Let's just save it and let's look at the changes. All right, now when you click on this, you see it's written by Zulekha. Okay, and also the version is displayed. All right, now we can see that all the other themes over here have a preview image. Okay, let's go ahead and add a preview image now. So our next step would be to add a file in our theme folder over here. And this file has to be named screenshot.png. Now I already have a PNG image in my system. I'm just going to paste it in this folder and I'll rename it to screenshot. Right, so this is the image that I already have. I'm just going to drag it into my themes 101 folder. Okay, so this is the screenshot. All right, so you see that we have the index.php file that we created and we have the style.css file. And I've also added an image called screenshot. Okay, now guys, you have to name it screenshot because WordPress is only looking for this particular named file. Now let's go and check our theme. Refresh. All right, now our theme looks pretty good. It has a cute little image of a dog and a kitten. Now our theme looks good. Let's go ahead and click on activate theme. Now, if we click on our dashboard over here in the pet adoption and click on view site, it's empty because we haven't added any code in our files yet. So our next step is to code. Now, guys, before we start coding, let's talk a little bit about PHP. WordPress is built and powered by PHP. So, guys, it's a plus point if you have prior knowledge about PHP. But if you don't, it's completely okay because the functions that we're going to use are all predefined WordPress functions. So we are all newbies over here, so don't worry. So what is PHP? Now, when we design a web page by using HTML, CSS, it's all design. It's a static page that does nothing. It doesn't return anything. It doesn't pull anything from a database. But when PHP is used with HTML, it does things like return pages, return blogs, return posts, and all of that. And we'll see how all of this happens in a bit. Now, PHP is used on the server side to return the requested resources. All right, now let's take it slow and let's look at a simple example. Okay, let's say that you want to output the name of the website that we created. Now, in order to do this, WordPress has defined a function called blog info. Okay, now this function returns information about your site. Now, let's say that you want the name of your website to be displayed. So let's see how that's done. Now, type with me, go to your index.php file. All right, now let's give a h2 tag. Now let's drop into PHP mode. All right, so this is how you drop into PHP mode. And to exit out of PHP, it's again a question mark and it's a greater than sign. Now when we've entered into PHP, let's type the name of this function, blog info. Now this function is basically used to return information about your website. So because we want to return the name, let's add a parameter called name over here. Okay, now let's just save this file and let's look at our site. Okay, so go back to WordPress. All right, click on view site. Now here you can see that it's given pet adoption. Now this is exactly what I named my website. Now from where is WordPress getting this information? Now I'll show you all from where it's actually getting it. Go back to the dashboard and scroll down to settings over here. Okay, now click on settings, go to general, and here you can see the site title. All right, the site title, this is where WordPress gets the website name from. Okay, let's try to change it. Let's name it Pet Adoption 101 and save changes and let's view the site. All right, now it changed to Pet Adoption 101. So basically this blog info function will pull information from WordPress. Okay, it'll basically pull the name of our website. Now let's try to change this to description. Okay, let's say I want to load the description of my website. Let's save and open up WordPress. Okay, it says just another WordPress site. Now again, let's look at where WordPress got this from. Here, the tagline says just another WordPress site. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to change the tagline. Okay, I'm going to name it do yourself a favor and adopt. All right, so this is the tagline of my website, do yourself a favor and adopt a lifesaver. Now, y'all can go ahead and add whatever tagline you want, whatever site title you want. Okay, you can play around with this a little bit. Okay, so I'm just going to save changes. Let's open up our site. Okay, now you can see that the changes are reflected. Now, this is all because of PHP. PHP is continuously connecting with the data which is stored in WordPress and it's pulling that data. Okay, now let's look at another example. Let's say that we want to display our blog posts on our website's homepage. So first to do this, we'll need to create a few blog posts. Okay, let's do that. All right, let's go to the dashboard and go to posts over here and click on add new. So after you click on add new, just add the name of your post. I'm going to name it dogs, right? I already have some random text that I've written about dogs. So I'm just going to paste that over here. Now click on publish. Right, so we have blog on dogs. Let's go ahead and make another post. Okay, we'll make another blog. I'm going to name it cats. All right, again, I have some data already about cats. I have stored it in a file. Okay, so I'm just randomly creating two posts over here, dogs and cats. You can create any random post, add any random data you want. And I'm just going to click on publish. Okay, now if you go to all posts, you'll see cats, dogs, and this hello world is a default post, which is already there. It says welcome to WordPress and all of that. Okay, now what you want to do is open up your index.php file. Okay, and let's add some code over here. Now what you do is let's enter into PHP mode again. Now just type with me and then I'll tell you what this does. All right. Now what this line means is quite simple. It's quite clear. It says that while we still have posts, keep looping through this loop. Okay. Now this the post function is another WordPress function that keeps a track of which posts we are working with. Okay. And it gets all the information about the next post. Now let's load the title of each of the posts that we just created. Okay, to do that, just drop back into HTML mode. And within this, I'm going to enter into PHP mode. Right over here, I'm going to add another PHP function called the title. All right. Now, obviously, the title function is used to return the title of each blog post. Okay, now let's also get the content of each blog post. To do that, just add the content function. Okay, now this is another function which just returns the content of your blog post. Right, so to do that, let's enter back into PHP mode. All right, we're going to call the function the content. Okay, now let's just save this and let's see if there are any changes to our website. All right, there is a small error. All right, so here I forgot to close PHP because here we are again opening HTML. So it's important that we close PHP, open HTML. And then again, enter into PHP and add this PHP function. Okay, so I just closed the PHP that I had opened over here. Okay, because in the next line, we're entering into HTML mode. Okay, now let's save and let's hope this works. All right, since we're closing PHP again over here, we want the loop to close while we're still in PHP. All right, so that's why I added another open PHP over here. And close PHP after the loop closes. Okay, let's save this and this should definitely work. All right, now we have all the titles of the blog posts. We have cats, we have dogs, and we have hello world. We also have the content of each of the blog posts. Okay, we have content of dogs, cats, and hello world. All right, so if y'all are still confused, let me go back and explain everything. So what I did here first was I used the blog info WordPress function, which returns information about your website. Okay, so I'll just take this off and put name over here. Okay, after that, I'm trying to display the blog post that we have on our WordPress. Okay, to do that, we're using this while loop. Okay, now this while loop is very important. And I've started this while loop in PHP and I need to make sure that we are in PHP when we're closing the while loop. Okay, that's why this last step, I know this might be a little bit confusing for beginners. But y'all will understand as we go on and try more examples. Okay. After that, we have this have post function. Now, this is quite simple. It just says that while we have post, run this code. Okay. Now, the post will just have the information about each post. After that, what we're doing is we are opening HTML tags and we're trying to print the title of each blog post. Similarly, we also want the content of each blog post to be displayed. So we drop back into PHP and we call this function called the underscore content. This function will just return the content of each of these blog posts. Okay, so this is basically the explanation. Now let's make things more interesting. So when we look at our page over here, what we want to do is let's load each blog on a separate page. So if we click on any of the blog titles, cats, dogs, or hello world, it should open up in a new page. So to do that, first, what we need to do is we need to change the blog titles into links, okay, into clickable links. So for those of you who know HTML, know to do that, we use anchor tags or A tags. So if you're familiar with HTML, you should know that these tags are used to provide links. All right. So what you can do is let's go back to our index.php file. We can add anchor tags to each of the title. So just open up your A tags and close them over here. Okay. So we're adding A tags to the title. Okay. All the titles will get the A tags now. And now what we can do is let's give it a href. Now, usually within the quotation marks over here, you enter a URL that usually takes you to the requested page. But WordPress has a predefined function that will output the URL for us. Okay, so what we're going to do is within these quotation marks, let's enter into PHP mode, right? Let's call that function. It's called the underscore permalink. Now let's save our file and let's open up our content. Okay, there is a problem on line number 6. Okay, I haven't closed PHP mode. So these silly mistakes always happen. So make sure you open and close the tags properly. Okay, let's open up. Okay, so I've just forgotten to close the A tags over here. Oh, there's a lot of confusion with closing and opening tags. Let's save. Okay, everything looks good now. All right, now all the three blog titles have a link. Okay, let's click on it. Okay, so this redirects us to our own page about cats. Okay, similarly, if we went back and went to dogs, it would open up a new page just about dogs. So guys, I forgot to show you all how the permalink works. Now, this function is basically to return a URL for each of the pages. Okay, now how it did that was, let's go back to our website. Now, if I click on cats, you can see that it's added this extension over here. So if I make this dogs, it should open up the page about dogs, correct? So it opens up the page about dogs. Similarly, if you go on Hello World, all right, it adds this extension over here. Okay, so this automatically generates URL for each page. Okay, but a problem here is that even after clicking these links and when you reach the page about cats, there is still a link on cats. Okay, we don't want this link because we're already on the cats page. Now, since the title of the post still appears as a link, what do we do is we remove that. Now, in order to remove that, we first go back to our text editor. Okay, let's go back and let's create a new file name, single.php. Okay, let's create this and then I'll tell you what I'm doing over here. Now let's type some random text and save it. Okay, let's just say, hi, this is Zuleika from Edureka. Okay, let's save it. And now go back to your website. Okay, now if I click on any of these pages, let's say I go to cats, it displays, hi, this is Zuleika from Edureka. Similarly, if I go to dogs, I'll get the same information. Now what's happening over here is, when we go to this main website or this home page, and whenever we click on any of these blog titles, the WordPress will look for a file called single.php. Okay, if it finds the file, then it will open a separate page powered by single.php. But if it doesn't find a file called single.php, then it will get powered by index.php itself. Now, because we added a single.php file over here, that's why anything that we enter within this singles.php file gets entered into these single pages. Now, when I go to cats, it will display whatever is written in the single.php, or it will run the single.php file. Okay. Now, before I didn't have a single.php file. That's why when I clicked on cats, only the information about cats was getting displayed. That's because the page was getting powered by index.php. Now, because we have singles.php, these single pages are going to get powered by single.php. Okay. I hope I'm clear. So now what we want to do is we want to display our blog posts in these single pages. Okay, to do that, let's go back to our code editor. Let's go to index.php. Let's copy this entire code and let's paste it in single.php. Also, I'm just going to remove the A tags because we don't want the blog titles to appear as links in the pages. Okay, so I'm just going to remove the A tags, save this, and let's open up our page. Okay, now when I click on cats, you can see that information about cats is displayed along with the title. Now this title is no more a link because I removed the A tags from the single.php file. Now this page is getting powered by single.php and this home page is getting powered by index.php. That's why the titles are still links over here. Okay, similarly, if I go to dogs, this is getting powered by single.php. You can see the title, which is without any link. All right. Right, now that we know how to play around with posts, let's look at how pages on WordPress work. Okay, so open up your WordPress dashboard. Okay, let's scroll down to pages over here and let's click on add new button. Okay, now to create a new page, let's give it a random name. To save some time, I already have a Word document which has each of my page and page description. So I'm going to go back to WordPress. I'm going to create an about page. Okay, about page. So just enter some random name and let's just enter some text. Okay, so I'm just going to copy this text. Enter any random text, guys. You can just type out some random stuff. Okay, so I'm just going to click on publish. Okay, now when I click on this permalink, you can see a permalink over here. If I click on this permalink, you can see that there is a link on this title. Now, this means that this page is powered by index.php. Okay, it's not powered by single.php. Now, this is because WordPress only uses the single.php file for individual posts. Okay, so the single.php file that we created over here is just for posts. But for individual pages, WordPress looks in our theme folder for another file called page.php. Okay, so now let's go back to our code editor and let's add a new file and we'll name it page.php. Okay, so let's just go back to single.php. Let's copy the entire code and paste it in page.php. Let's save this and let's open up the page. Okay, so this is the permalink. Click on it. All right. Now you can see that the title is not a link, which means that this page is no longer powered by index.php. Instead, it's powered by page.php. Okay. Now that we have a page and we also have a few posts, let's add headers and footers. Okay, let's add headers and footers to our pages and our blogs. Now to do that, open up a new file called header.php. Okay, so go back to your text editor over here and let's add a new file. Name it header.php. Let's just add some random text. Let's say this is the header. Okay, and let's just save this. Okay, now open up your index.php file. Now at the beginning or at the topmost line, just add this line of code. Okay, enter into PHP mode and call this function getHeader. Okay, so y'all can guess what this function does. It basically displays the content of header.php file. Okay, so let's just save this and let's open up our website. Okay, now you can see on the website over here, it says this is the header. Now let's go back to our text editor and just like how we added the header, let's add the footer. Okay, let's add another file. Let's name it footer.php. Okay, let's add some random text. This is the footer. Okay, let's save it and go back to your index.php file. Okay, and go to the bottom of the page and drop into PHP mode. Call the getFooter function. All right, you guessed it. This function will obviously return the contents of footer.php file. Okay, so let's save this up and let's open up our website. Refresh. Okay, you see that this is the footer. Okay, there's a small typo, but yeah. So this is how you load headers and footers. Now, obviously, this looks very unprofessional. No website has a header called this is the header or this is the footer. So this is just basic examples I'm giving you. Now, if I open up any of these posts, you'll see that you don't get the header or the footer. This is because these posts are powered by single.php file, correct? This is powered by single.php and this page is powered by index.php. So what we need to do is we need to go to our single.php file, add headers and footers. Let's also do this for pages because when we go back to our dashboard, okay, if I click on this about page that we created, here also you don't see any header or footer because these pages are powered by page.php. And in the page.php, we haven't added any header or footer function. Okay, so go back to your code editor and let's go to single.php. Okay, right on the top, let me just copy this getHeader function and I'll paste it over here. Okay. Similarly, we'll copy the getFooter function and I'll paste it over here. Okay, so for singles.php, we have getHeader and getFooter functions. Okay, this getHeader and getFooter will call header.php and footer.php respectively. Okay, similarly for page.php also, we need to add these two functions. So let's go back to page.php and on the top, let's add the header. Okay, and at the bottom, we'll add the footer. Okay, let's save both of these files. Now let's open up our website. Okay, right now I'm on a page. So yeah, on this page, you can see this is the header and this is the footer. So we've successfully added that. Let's view our site and let's go to each of these blog posts. Okay, over here also we have this is the header, this is the footer. So basically the footer and header functions are working because right now we added the header and footer functions in single.php and page.php. Okay. Now let's see how to add CSS file and make it reflect on WordPress. Okay, obviously our website looks too dull and nobody has a website like this. So open up your code editor. Okay, let's open it up and let's go to your header.php. Okay, let's just clear this random text that we have over here. So just like how we link a CSS file into a HTML file, let's add code that does the same thing. So for those of you who know HTML, know that this is how a HTML file is started. Okay, so we have the document type, then we add the HTML tags, and then we also have the head tags. Whenever we are on a HTML file and we want to link a CSS file, we always link our CSS file in the head. Okay, so that's what we're going to do over here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to drop into PHP and I'm going to call a function, which is WP underscore head. Now, this function basically lets WordPress be in control of our head section. So basically, this takes care of loading files or plugins and all of that. Now, the only thing left to do is to load the CSS file. To do this, let's create a new file called functions.php. Okay, so add and let's name it functions.php. Now, this file is a bit different from the other files that we created. The other files were mainly for structuring our website, but this file is for communicating with WordPress and requesting for various resources like loading files, plugins, and all of that. And let's call a WordPress function named addAction. Okay, add underscore action. This function takes up two arguments. So before we discuss that, let me tell you what this function does. This function basically lets us give instructions to WordPress to perform some action. So in the first argument to this function, you will tell WordPress what you want to do. Okay, so in our case, we want to load our CSS file. To do that, we use a WordPress hook name, which is, let me type it out for you, WP underscore on QUUE underscore scripts. All right, now guys, this argument WP on Q scripts has to be spelled out exactly like I've done it. Okay, this argument tells WordPress that you want to load some script. Okay, now this script can be your CSS file or it can be your JavaScript file. Now the second argument is a function that we define and WordPress runs this function for us. Okay, so it can be any function, you can name it whatever you want. All right, so let's just make up a name for a function and shortly we'll see what the function does. Okay, so I'm gonna name it a pet data. All right. Now above this line, let's create the pet data function, okay? So let me just repeat what this add action does. It basically performs some function for you. Now this function has two arguments. The first argument is what task you want WordPress to do. Now this argument basically tells that you want to load some script, okay? This can be JavaScript or it can be CSS. The second argument is a function that we defined, okay? Now let's see what this function does. Okay, so type this out with me. To create a function, we have to add the keyword function and the name of the function, which is pet underscore data. Since it's a function, it'll have parentheses and yeah, let's open up the function. Now, just type this out with me. I'll tell you what exactly is happening. All right, so basically in the body of this function, we're just going to load our CSS file. Okay, to do that, there's a function called WP on Q style. Now, because it's a CSS style sheet, that's why this says style. Okay. So we're trying to load a CSS file over here. Now this function also takes two arguments. Okay, the first argument is made up name for our CSS style sheet. Okay, so let's just name it something like pet adoption styles. Now the second argument is basically a location that points to the CSS file. So WordPress has another function named get underscore style sheet underscore URI. And open up your website, refresh. There is some problem with this. So guys, I made a very silly mistake over here. I forgot to enter into PHP mode and close PHP. So guys, let me just explain this file to you once again. Okay, so what we did is first we started off with the add action WordPress function. Now this function basically tells WordPress to do something. This function takes two arguments. The first argument is the task that we want WordPress to do. Okay, and the second argument is the name of the function defined by us. Now this argument basically tells WordPress that we want to load a script, either JavaScript or CSS file. Okay, and the second argument is basically a name of the function. Now this is the function that we are defining over here. Now this function will basically load our CSS file. Okay, the WP on Q style function is for returning a CSS file. Okay, so this function is basically used for a CSS file. The first argument to this function is basically a random name that we're giving to our style sheet. Now, the second argument is basically a location that points to our CSS file. Now, let's just save our file. Now, going back to our style.css file, just add the small code snippet. Okay, so we're just selecting the entire body and changing its color to green. Okay, I'll tell you why we did this. So let's just save our changes to style.css, header.php, functions.php. Okay, just save your changes. Otherwise, your changes will not load. Now go back to your website. All right. Now you can see that everything has turned green. Now, because everything turned green, we know that our style sheet is loaded successfully. Okay, now why did this turn green? Go back to your code editor. In the style.css file, we added the small code snippet. Okay, we made sure that the color of the body turned green. Now we added this code block just to test if our CSS file had loaded. Now guys, you can go ahead and erase this. So if you try to change the color and let's say we'll set the color to red. Okay, now let's save and let's see if it gets reflected. All right, so everything turned red over here. This means that our CSS style sheet is successfully loaded. So let's go back and we can clear this code snippet. All right, there's one last thing to do. Now open up your dashboard. Okay, now if you open WordPress dashboard, you see a black bar at the top. Now our next task is to load that black bar on our website. Okay, to do this, open up your header.php file. So let's go to header.php and move the body ending tag and HTML ending tag into the footer.php. So I forgot to add the body tags. What we're going to do is we're going to move the body ending tag and the HTML ending tag into our footer.php file. Okay, let's just copy this and let's move it to our footer.php. Now we're doing this because we obviously want our body elements to end at the footer. We don't want them to end immediately at the header. Okay, so we want the header, then we want the body, and then we want the footer. Now in your footer.php, right before closing the body and HTML tag, let's load another WordPress function. Okay, so jump into PHP mode and we load another function called WP underscore footer. Now what this function does is it tells WordPress to load all the necessary files, resources, and menu bars, everything before closing the HTML and body tags. So anything that needs to be loaded before you close the body and the HTML tags. All right, now let's just save the file and let's go back to our website. Now you can see the menu bar on top. Okay, it says howdy, Edureka, and all that. So guys, our next task is to design our WordPress theme so that it's up and running. So far, our WordPress theme and website looks quite dull. It has no design. It looks boring, absolutely boring. No website actually looks like this. And what we're going to do is we're going to start adding styles and some life to our project. So guys, in this tutorial, I'm not going to teach you how to code CSS and HTML and how to design your website. So guys, if you want to learn CSS, HTML, I'll leave the links in my description. You can check out those contents. But in this tutorial, I'm strictly going to stick to WordPress. I'm not going to show you how to design CSS and how to accomplish all of that. So to make things easier, I've already stored a HTML and CSS file in my system. Now, these two files basically are building a simple static web page. So what we're going to do is we're going to learn how to integrate HTML and CSS in our WordPress. Okay, but if you guys want to create your own web page using HTML and CSS, then I'll leave a link in the description about how to create a web page using HTML and CSS. Okay, so I have my HTML and CSS code in a separate folder over here. All right, this is the folder. And let me just show you how the web page looks. All right, so this is a web page I've created. It is a static web page and none of these links actually work because I've just designed it using HTML and CSS. So this is just like a design template. Okay, so what we're going to do is we'll be adding the HTML and CSS code of this web page into our WordPress theme. Okay, so we'll just be copy pasting the code from this folder to the WordPress theme. So guys, I know most of you will not have HTML CSS code ready on your system. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave the HTML and CSS code in a link in the description box. Y'all can go and download this code from there and use this. Now what we're going to do is we're going to begin with moving this header portion into our website. Okay, this header part, this entire header part, we'll move it into our WordPress. So what I'll be doing is I'll just be copying the HTML code for the header section into the header.php file. So from here, I'm going to select the code until here, end header. Okay, I'm just going to copy this entire code and go to my themes folder and over here, go to header.php and I'm going to paste it over here. Okay, so I'm just pasting it in the body section of the header.php file. Now save this file and let's just refresh our WordPress theme. So this is our WordPress theme, refresh it. Here you can see all of these buttons and all of that content. Now, I know this is not structured, but first let's just load the header, footer, and all of those areas. After that, we'll structure and style it. Now, similarly, let's add the footer section into our WordPress site. So I'm just going to my website folder, and in the index.html file, I'm going to scroll down to footer. Okay, so I'm just going to copy the footer code. All right, I'll copy this into footer.php. Themes folder and go to footer.php. Now, before closing the body tags, you need to add the footer.php. So let's just clear this. This is the footer. We'll paste it over here. Okay, let's just save this and let's open up our let's open our WordPress. All right. So here you get the footer. Okay, now let me show you the footer. Okay, so basically this entire thing got loaded over here. Okay, so now we've added the structure of the header and footer. Let's add the design part. All right, so let's add the CSS file. To do that, I'll open up the CSS file and copy the entire code and paste it into the style.css file that we created earlier. So I'm copying this entire style.css file and I'm going to go to my themes folder wherein I have another style.css file. All right, this is where we mentioned about our theme, the theme name. I'm just going to paste this entire code over here. Okay, let's save this and let's go back to our WordPress theme. You can see a little bit of design. I know it's a little bit out of line. It's not aligned properly, but we'll do all of that. Don't worry about all of that right now. Okay, so we'll fix this gradually. Now, instead of these dummy posts over here, dogs, cats, and hello world and all of that, let's add some pet adoption design. Okay, so let's add the content onto our WordPress site. To do that, let's go back into the HTML file. Let's copy the body part. Okay, apart from the header and the footer, let's copy everything else. Okay, the header ends here, so I'm going to copy from here. Okay, and I'm going to copy till here. I've copied exactly till the footer starts. Okay, this is where the footer starts. So I've copied it till here. Only this much is the body part. Okay, now copy this and paste it in your index.php file. Okay, this is the index.php file in our themes folder. Now, obviously, we want the header and the footer to be displayed. Now let's remove this loop, which was used for displaying all the dummy posts that we created. Okay, let's remove it and let's paste the HTML body part. Okay, so I pasted this part. Let's save it and let's open up our WordPress theme. Okay, now this looks much better, but you can see that the main image here is missing. So what I'm going to do is, this is the image that I've added on the main page. What I'm going to do is I'm going to move this entire images folder into the themes folder. Okay. Let's click on move. So I've added the images folder into our WordPress theme folder. Now if you load the page, okay, you still don't get the image because we haven't told WordPress where to look for the images. Okay, so let's open up the index.php file. Now when I'm loading the image, I've mentioned the location of the image to be in the images folder, but I've not mentioned the path to the images folder over here. Okay, I've said images folder, correct? So I'm basically loading this dogcat.jpg image. But in my index.php file, I've just mentioned the path as images. And then within that, there is the image. Now, which might seem true to you because there's a folder called images over here within which I have dogcat. But we haven't loaded the entire path. Okay, so basically this images is in themes 101 folder, which is inside WP site. We have to load the entire path. Okay, so let's mention the path to the images folder. So the images folder is basically in the WP content folder, within the themes and then into the theme 101 folder. Okay, now within the theme 101, I have the image folder. Okay, so let me just mention that path. So first it starts off with WP content. Okay, followed by the themes folder, followed by theme 101. All right, now within the theme 101 is the images folder, and within the image folder is this JPG image. All right, so now the path seems right, correct? Now let's just save and let's go back to our WordPress theme. All right, now we've got the image loaded. So we have this cute little image on our website. Now next we'll need a generic page so that when we click on, let's say I click on the about link, or if I click on the breeds link, it should open up a generic page, okay? A generic page that displays our WordPress pages and posts. To do that, we need a constant page template. Now this WordPress site is basically the home page, but we need another template that holds the content for our other pages like about, breed, adoption. For all of this, we need another page which can hold our content. All right. Now in my website folder that contained the HTML and CSS code for this website, I had another file called innerpage.html. Okay. So let's go back to my folder. So this was my website folder. There's innerpage.html. Now, if we display this page, okay, we see a different template. Now we're going to use this template for displaying our WordPress pages. Okay, so all the WordPress pages that we create, we're going to display them using this template. So before we add the page template into our WordPress theme, let's actually create some WordPress pages. So go back to the WordPress dashboard. Okay, I'm going to go back to dashboard and click on the pages. Okay, here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to create four new pages over here. So we have an about page over here. All right, to make our pages look more attractive, I've stored some images for each of these pages. So for about page, I'll have a different image. So what I'm going to do is I'll show you the folder. Like I have different images for each of these pages. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to load all of these images so that our pages look more attractive. It should look like a real website. Okay, so this is exactly what I'm trying to do. You can skip this step or you can, you know, do anything else you want. So I'm going to load this image. To do that, let's go back to my post over here and I'm going to add the image over here. Okay, so let's say add media and I'm going to upload file. Okay, let's update. Let's look at how the page looks. So this is how the page looks without the page template that I'm going to add in a while. The inner page.html template will be used for displaying these pages. So once I add it, it'll look much better. Similarly, I'm going to create few more pages. Adoption. So similarly, I had an adoption page. So I just copy pasted some text from the internet. Okay, some random text from the internet. I added this image and let's update it. All right, so similarly, I'll add another page. Let's call it Breathes. I have the content for this page as well. So I'm going to copy this entire content. And I'm also going to import a few images over here. Similarly, I'll add another image. And one more husky image. Guys, I'm a huge fan of animals, so I love pets. So that's why I've made this whole tutorial about pet adoption. Okay, so this cute husky, let's add this image as well and insert into post. All right, so I'm going to publish this post as well. Okay, so now we have about adoption breeds and this privacy policy was created by default. Okay, and let's add one last page. Okay, so add new. Let's call it contact. So I'm going to make this as realistic as possible. All right, so you all get a real idea about how websites are created. Okay, I'll copy this information that I had for contact page and I'm just going to paste it over here. Let's publish this as well. Okay, so if we go to our pages, we have about, adoption, breeds, contact, and this privacy policy, which is already created. We have a sample page. You can go ahead and delete this page. All right, so now let's try to display this page. Okay, let's display this page. Okay, now this obviously doesn't look like a good web page. So now let's add the inner page template for these pages. To do that, I'll open up the website folder. So let's go back to our code editor. Now inside this website folder, I have the innerpage.html code. Since we already have the header and footer sections, let's just copy the leftover body section. Okay, so just select the body section, which starts over here. And it ends over here. I'm just going to copy this. And now what you're going to do is you're going to open up page.php in your themes folder. And now when you open the page, we still want the header and footer functions. We also want this while loop, which displays our post. But let's delete this page, though we don't need the name of our web page. Okay, and also let's delete this content function. Okay, because we don't want that content for now. So right after closing our PHP tag over here, while we're still in HTML, just paste the entire code. Okay, so I've pasted the code over here. Now let's just clear this part first. Now on your page.php file, go to this line wherein I've defined the name of the page, which is welcome page. Okay, now this name is getting displayed over here. Now we don't want this to display welcome page because this is actually the about page, correct? It's the about page. So we want about to be displayed over here. Okay. And if I click on breeds, then I want breeds to be displayed over here. Similarly, if I go to adoption, then adoption should be displayed over here. So to do that, let's clear this up. Okay. So I'm going to clear this and I'm going to add a WordPress function instead. This function will just fetch the page title for us. So first of all, just drop into PHP mode and let's call the title function. Okay, we've already dealt with this function before. Okay, let's call this function. Okay, let's save and let's refresh. Okay, so now you can see that this has changed the title. The title is now about. Okay, it makes sense because we are in the about page right now. All right, so now that we've loaded the title, we want the content about page to get displayed. Okay, this is not the content of the about page. Let me show you the about page. Let's go back to the dashboard and let's go to pages. So this is the content of the about page. Now I want this content to be displayed whenever I go to the about page. Okay, so when I go to visit site, sorry, I need to go to pages. So I want this content to be displayed. Okay, but when I visit my about page, I get some other content. What we want is we want WordPress to fetch the content from my about page. Okay, so whatever I've created, I want WordPress to fetch that and display it. Now to do that, let's just open up our page.php file again. Okay, let's scroll down here. Okay, you can see the dummy content over here after this paragraph. Okay, so instead of this paragraph, let's just clear this paragraph up. Okay, instead of this, I want WordPress to display the content from the about page. To do that, let's drop into PHP mode over here and let's call the function the_content. Okay, now let's just save the file and let's see if this worked. Refresh. All right, now we have our content loaded. I know this is not aligned properly. That's because we haven't added our image over here. Okay, so let's load the image into this page and after that we'll align everything else. Okay, so to load the background image, we have to just specify the path to the image. When you go to your page.php file here, within the URL, you'll see images and dog cat image. Okay, we need to do the exact same thing that we did in index.php. We loaded the path to the images folder. Okay, so let's just copy it till here. Okay, and I'm going to go back to page.php and I'll paste it over here. Okay, now I'm loading the background image. Let's save it and let's refresh. The about page looks really nice. Okay, so this is exactly how we want our breeds, adoption and contact, every other page to look like. All right. So now everything looks good over here except the title of this page. Okay, you can see it's written pet adoption hyphen local hyphen about. Okay, so since this is an about page, we should be seeing about over here. Okay, so instead of having all of this, we should just be seeing about over here. So how do we change that? To do that, let's go back to our code editor. Okay, now let's go to functions.php file. Now, since we want WordPress to change the title of a page depending on which page we're on, we must use the add action function, which tells WordPress to perform some action at a particular time. Okay, like how we use this add function over here to load pet data function, exactly how we added this function over here, we're going to add another add action function. All right, so let's just drop down over here and let's call the add action function. Okay, just like how we did earlier. Now, like I spoke earlier, that this function will have two arguments. The first argument is the task that you want WordPress to do, and the second is a user defined function. Okay, so our first argument is, just type it with me. Okay, after underscore set up underscore theme. All right, and our second argument is basically some function that we make up. Okay, let's name this as page title. All right, silly mistake over here. So guys, you can name this whatever you want. I've just named it page title. Now let's create a function called page title. Okay, now that we've defined the function over here, let's create the function. Okay, so function page title. Now before I go into the body of this function, let me tell you what this after setup theme does. This is basically a WordPress event hook, okay, and it must be spelled exactly like how I've spelled it. Okay, this is because it's a predefined hook. Okay, so you can't change the name. Okay, let's create the page title function. Now just type this function out with me. I'll tell you what it does. All right, now this add theme support function basically lets you enable different features. Okay, so for your theme, if you want features like title tags and all that, it'll let you enable different features for your theme. Okay, over here we're enabling the title tag feature. Okay, so this is our page title function. Now let's just save this file and let's just refresh our WordPress theme. Perfect. Now we have about over here. Okay, this changed to about and the name of our website, which is Pet Adoption. Okay, so if I remove this and if I go here, it says Pet Adoption. But if I add the about tag over here, right, the title of the page changes to about. Okay, this is exactly how I wanted it. Now the last thing we're going to do is to get these links to work. Okay, so when I click on these links, they should direct me to the about page, to the breeds page, to the adoption page, and so on. So to do this, let's go back to our header.php file over here and scroll down to this line. Okay, now in this about section over here, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go back to my about page. I'll copy this link. Okay, and let's go back to this link over here. This is where you mention the URL that you want to be directed to. So I'm just going to paste this URL over here. Okay, let's save this and let's go back to our website. Okay, now if I click on about, this leads me to the about page. Okay, so I just added the link of this page into my A tags. Okay, this is where you mention the URL that you want to be directed to. Okay, so this is where I added my URL. And I'm just going to copy this URL and also paste it in the footer.php file. Okay, so here about us, I'm going to paste it over here. And I've saved it over here as well. All right. Now, similarly, for all the pages, we need to do this. So let's go back over here. Let's go to our dashboard. Okay, let's go to our pages and let's go to adoption. Okay, first let's preview this page. Okay, so when I go to adoption, it's actually taking the content from my pages. Okay, this is how the pet adoption page looks. I'm just going to copy this link. Okay, and let's go back to my headers.php. Then adoption, I'm going to paste this. Okay, similarly for my footers.php, I'll go to the adoption homes and I'll paste this link. Right, and let's do this for all of the other pages. Okay, now if I refresh, if I go to about, okay, it takes me to the about page. If I go to adoption, it'll take me to the adoption page. This looks like a brand new website. Okay, now similarly for the breed and the contact page and the home page, we need to do this. So for the home, breed and contact page, we need to do this. Okay, so let's go back to our dashboard. Okay, and let's just quickly review breeds. Okay, this is how the breeds page looks. Okay, this looks really cute, guys. Okay, I'm just going to copy this link and we'll go to our footer, paste it in the link, and similarly go to header.php, go to the A tag in breeds and paste it. Okay, I'm going to save it, and let's also do it for contact and also for the home link, and for the contact link also I need to add the URL. So let's go back over here. Okay, this is the home page basically. I'm just going to copy this URL and I'll paste it here. Okay, and we have one last page left, which is contact. So about is working. Okay, if I click on about, if I go on breeds, it's directing me to the breeds page. And if I go on adoption, it takes me to the adoption page. If I go to home, it takes me to the home page. And similarly here, if I try breeds, it'll take me to the breeds page. If I go to adoption homes, it'll take me to the adoption page. Okay, now we need to add for contact as well. So go back to the dashboard. All right, I'm going to go to my pages. Y'all can just change the path over here otherwise, but I'll just show it to you like this. So this is my contact page. Let's view the contact page. Okay, this is how the contact page looks. I'm going to copy this URL and going back to my headers.php, I'll paste it over here. Okay, save it. And that's it. Also, I've made the title of this page Pet Home. I've made it clickable. Okay, so here also I'm going to add a link. So I'm going to add the home page link itself. Okay, so I'm copying this home page link. Now I'm going to go to my title of the page, which is Pet Home. And here also I have an A tag. Okay, so I'm going to remove this hashtag and I'm going to add the URL to my home page. So save, and now everything should work. So refresh. All right, so if I go to home, if I go to about, this is the about page. If we go to breeds, this is the breeds page. Okay, I've also added external links in my page. So if I click on genetic isolation, it takes me to Wikipedia. Okay, and then there is adoption page. Okay, these are really cute little puppies, and when you go to contact, we have another page for contact. Okay, and also the logo over here, if I click on it, it'll take me to the home page. Okay, this is exactly how you add links and all of that to your website. So guys, this is our final website. This is how it looks. Okay, so we have all the links working in this website. We have a beautiful, a very cute website about pet adoption. Okay, y'all can try a different website. Y'all can build a website about cars, bikes, or anything that you're interested in, or even a recipe website. So guys, that was a lot of work, but it was definitely worth it because you now know how to set up your own theme and your own website on WordPress. So give yourself a pat on the back because you've done a really, really good job. So guys, with this, we come to the end of today's session. If you have any doubts regarding the session, please leave them in the comment section and we'll get back to you at the earliest. Okay, I hope all of you enjoyed this session with me. I know it was a little bit lengthy, but this session covered the entire WordPress development. So we developed a theme and we published our website locally. Okay, you all can go ahead and share your websites with us. We'll be more than happy to know how far you've reached. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Have a great day.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to EduReka channel to learn more. Happy learning!